3, 2, 1, go.
Perfect.
But we're gonna put some jazz music behind the
like.
No!
Muncher.
What's happening, Munchers? My name is Harsh.
And I'm Shreyas.
Welcome to the goodbadfilmy.
Yo.
What are we doing today, Vatya?
We're doing the pinnacle in Sam Raimi's trilogy, Spider-Man 3.
This one is so bad. I was so disappointed with this one. The first two, I really like.
Yeah.
If you guys haven't seen those, go check out our reviews below.
Yeah.
This one just blew my mind in the not so good way.
Yeah, man. I mean, it was such a disappointment. And to see like just the way all of these arcs just ended and like abruptly half-hearted bullshit, like what was going on?
I have no idea. I think there's a lot going on behind the scenes as well from what I've heard.
Yeah.
After the movie was done in post-production, there was a lot of shit happening.
Yeah.
But yeah, it completely did affect the movie.
Right.
And yeah, there were some really nice things sprinkled throughout the movie. Even some villains were really well done.
Yeah.
Some story arcs were well done. But all in all, this was, so bad.
Yeah, man.
Let's just get into the goods first.
Okay.
Yeah.
If you have to. We're introduced to like a new villain now. We've got Sandman, baby. And this goes all the way back from like the first movie.
Absolutely.
You know, he's the one who actually accidentally kills Uncle Ben.
Uncle Ben, right.
Right. And just like the way he becomes Sandman, the effects, the way Spider-Man has to fight him, really cool stuff.
His own backstory
Yes. Is
really, really well done.
Yeah, you really feel for him. Yeah.
Yeah. So, and he's a very sympathetic villain
Yes. That
you can, you know, latch onto. And
yes.
I really like everything about Sandman.
Totally.
I really wish this movie is just contained towards Sandman.
Yes.
And it was a story about, you know, Spider-Man and Sandman.
Yes.
And that, you know, him finding that clarity or that,
absolutely,
you know, resolution with about
he gets closure. Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
About Uncle Ben's death.
Yes.
So, but this movie just tried cramping in so much.
Yeah, and I guess,
it falters.
Yeah, I mean, even like there's one particular scene right in the end, you know, the penultimate fight scene, and you know, Harry Osborn and Peter Parker are really, you know, at each other's
right. Throats.
There's a lot of stuff going on, and Spider-Man realizes, you know, shit's against him, and he just goes to him like for help, and he's like, bro, I really need your help. MJ's
yeah.
in trouble, you know, both of us like her. Can you please help me? And he's still stubborn, and he's like,
yeah.
No, bro, I'm not turning up.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then you literally see Spider-Man almost dying, and
yeah.
Spider-Man never freaking gives up.
Yeah.
And to see him like at his the lowest of low, like, you know, how does he come out from this? And you all get this like,
redemption, dude. What a redemption arc for Harry Osborn. The
yes.
way done.
Junior
I
Goblin,
really,
baby.
Liked it.
Yes.
So I think the overall way this concludes Harry Osborn's arc, this
is
movie
super.
Is phenomenal.
Right.
Sandman is phenomenal
yes.
as a you know,
yeah.
villain.
Right.
You can really latch onto him. You can understand him. And he, even his, the way he, you know, his mannerisms,
yes.
the way he talks.
Right.
You can understand that this guy, a guy in pain.
Yes.
Who's been, you know, done wrong.
Correct.
And he's just fighting against circumstances
yes.
and stuff.
Yeah.
So yeah, you feel for him as well.
Right.
Absolutely. And how are we forgetting the jazz walk, bro?
Oh my god, yeah, the jazz walk.
Oh my god.
Yeah, that's one of our favorite scenes
it's
in this
so
movie.
It's so bad that it's so good, and I've watched it a billion times just because of that.
Black Spider-Man, Black Peter Parker.
You know what I'm talking about, the emo guy.
With the hair down
hair.
And like pointing at
so
women
good.
And stuff. It's the best shit ever.
Yeah,
you gotta
I'm
check
really
that stuff out.
I'm running out of good things to say about this movie.
Let's just dive into the bad now.
There are so many bad things in this movie. Topher Grace, who cast him? What is he doing in this movie?
I mean, I'm kind of glad that he's casted as such a bad Venom, because we got to see like Tom Hardy as the actual Venom.
That's fine, but what is why he ruins this movie single-handedly?
He can't even do Eddie Brock properly.
He's shoehorned in his entire Venom arc is shoehorned into this
his
movie.
His dialogues are random.
Venom himself is so annoying.
He's like this reptilian alien who's just like...
He's a small, flimsy, light-skinned
yeah.
man,
but
Venom's
going to
be huge ass.
Yeah,
and
badass,
yeah.
Oh my god. So Venom was just like, seemed like they finished like 90% of the movie
yeah.
and they're like, oh, wait a second, maybe we should
more
put this
toys.
In.
Venom toys.
Yeah, and like, what were you guys thinking? It was so bad. And then just to shoehorn Venom in, you make
absolutely.
Peter Parker go black and
yeah.
random and all nasty and shit. And then, you know, he's freaking like beating up MJ and shit, so... What is Gwen Stacy doing?
Happening?
Oh my god, this is such a shit show of
absolutely.
All that good work from the first two movies to like come to this. Oh, what was going
especially
on?
After the second one, which was phenomenal, coming down to this one.
Yes.
The kind of, even the story beats, the way he slips into villainy, Peter Parker himself. goes becomes an emo guy.
Yeah.
And he's just being a dick to everyone around him.
Yeah.
And I'm like, what's happening here?
Yeah, it's so weird. And we actually saw this interview where Tobey was talking about how he spoke to Sam Raimi about how deep and dark he can go into like this Peter Parker. Are you kidding me? Like, what can we like figure out what conversations those were? Because without those conversations, you probably would have done better.
Probably.
Jesus Christ. And yeah, I mean, this basically comes down to the fact that, you know, Sam Raimi probably wasn't interested. He had had movie contracts of Spider-Man 4 and 5, right. And I think this shit, you know, hit the fan with this movie. It didn't work out with the production.
Pre-production, there was a lot of stuff going on behind the scenes as well.
Right.
You told me he was fired behind the scenes, but pre-production was on after the shooting was done.
Absolutely.
So I'm pretty sure all of that really affected the movie. I'm sure if Sam Raimi was still on board, we'd go and get a completely different movie.
Yeah. This was almost like a Justice League Zack Snyder thing, right?
Yeah.
The Snyder cut. We want the Raimi cut.
Yeah, absolutely. Give it to us.
Yeah, and despite like liking, you know, Harry Osborn and, you know, his redemption, considering how good Green Goblin's sort of character was, and in terms of like his suit and his glider, freaking Junior Goblin has a skateboard.
Like, I think that's cool, actually.
I don't know. I mean, the only cool thing I liked about him was like his helmet and the way it like goes back in and out. You know, we saw that with Iron Man doing it so well. Yeah,
really nice.
But apart from that, I think his suit was like kind of worse.
Absolutely. And Mary Jane is still a pain in the ass. She's done nothing throughout the series. I have no idea why she was cast. I think Gwen Stacy would have been a better choice.
Oh my god, Gwen Stacy, like she's cute and stuff, but like there's one part where she's doing like a pin-up shoot like in an office.
She's relegated to such a sidey role.
Yeah, so weird.
All of that doesn't work. So many people are just shoehorned into this entire plot.
Very random.
There are so many subplots overall, you know,
just not
up
fitting
them. It's not even done well. They're not even wrapped up well. I can go on and on about this movie, going on a rant, but does it do that in the Filmy?
But how do you hate on like Mopi MJ, man? She's back to red hair now. Filmy it is. Sam Raimi, you know, messing up, you know, with the production, you know, team, in not even finishing the movie and stuff properly. Like, he had almost leaked storyboards of Spider-Man 4 where he was setting a Mysterio and the Sinister Six were going to come in and Venom was going to like be a bigger, better character, probably Carnage as well.
And after you've given a guy three movies, I think that's justified. After three movies, it's a little justified.
Yeah.
Him doing it. And I was really, really looking forward to all of this, man.
Totally, like, man. I mean, it was a shit show and we don't know what was going on. And
what a final sad ending to a finale, like,
yeah, man, finale. It's such an anti-climax.
No, and not just that, right after this we got the Amazing Spider-Man,
which was worse probably, right?
Okay,
yeah. And imagine like what they could have done, like we got Venom with Tom Hardy and if this would have continued, but yeah, end of Tobey Maguire, end of Mopey stuff, we got cutesy Andrew Garfield. Oh my god, Sony not doing that thing.
Yeah, absolutely. So I think this was the start of the disaster for Sony as
right.
I think they should have just stuck with Sam Raimi. They had found a winning formula and they didn't stick to it, which is very, very surprising.
Right.
And but I do, again, you know, that's how these companies work.
Yeah, man. It's
producers and
irritating.
You're poking directors and, you know, not even letting them do their thing.
Yeah, so.
So but yeah, overall this was really disappointing.
Yeah, now I'm scared to get into the rating now. You know, this whole trilogy was like anticlimactic with this movie, and I'd still watch it because there's stuff that I like, especially like about Sandman. I was mentioning there's this one particular scene, you know, with obviously he's Sandman, but the first time Spider-Man encounters him, they actually got this amputated guy to put on the suit so he could like punch through him.
Yeah.
So yeah, so just for scenes like that, I would happily watch it, and hence it's a one and done for me.
Yeah, absolutely. I can't agree more with you. Yep. So Sam Raimi, especially, just props to him for pulling off this wonderful trilogy.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, even though the final, you know, movie didn't land,
the first one worked really well. Yeah.
So probably just for that, I would probably watch it again.
Yeah.
But yeah, I would still call it one and done.
Exactly.
Don't waste your time with this one, guys.
Right.
So yeah, that wraps up our review of Spider-Man 3.
Sam Raimi to an end.
Finally done. And yeah, like, share, subscribe, share this video with all your friends. Let us know which movie from the trilogy is your favorite. Thank you so much. We're finally done with this.
Yo.
We had to sit through this again. Yeah, Hangout is done. See you guys.
Bye-bye.
Really soon. Yeah, cheers.
Thank you so much for watching Good Band Filmy. If you want to, you know, keep a check on us, follow what cool stuff we're doing. Instagram's right there. We're doing a bunch of videos. You can subscribe right there.
Please do.
And yeah, this is a Geek Alert, man. So we've got a lot of stuff going on down below. You can check us out, you know, whatever we've been up to. And yeah, keep, you know, stay in touch for more stuff, baby.
Be back for more.
Yo.